The whole concept of the whole idea is to bring good food at an affordable price to customers. My name is Jimmy Teo. I'm the co-founder and chef of Made for Meat at Brunner's Coffee Shop. I'm 40 this year actually. I've been in the industry for about 20 years now, half of it in Australia and half of it here. Started out as a dishwasher, moved up to the main kitchen, pretty much the basics, cutting and everything. Worked my way up to where I am now. Previously, I worked at a couple of places, but I think the most notable one is Woolloomooloo Steakhouse, Dan Ryan's American Steakhouse, and there's probably Rabbit Carrigan as well. The dishes I'll be serving today will be the Beef Wellington, New Zealand Lamb Cutlets, Jimmy's Carbonara, and the Australian ribeye. I source my meat from the suppliers that are available in Singapore and then get them to bring us a sample. For example, the Australian ribeye. There'll be different types of beef from different farms in Australia. So the one that we have now, it's actually, the marbling is excellent. The fats is just unbelievable. It is free range as well, and it is Australian. We don't normally do what Western store does. We don't do deep fried items. We don't do fish and chips. We don't do fries. That's one thing. The other thing is we use our own spice, my own seasoning that I do myself, that it takes about 2 weeks to marinate and to produce. I'm pretty sure everywhere else either use salt and pepper or they use bought seasoning. Okay, for the Beef Wellington, it's a piece of tenderloin. I season the tenderloin, sear it over the charcoal grill. Once it's done to rare, take it off the grill. Then you take out the puff pastry, you brush the mushroom duxel, the foie gras, the tenderloin, and you wrap it up. Brush it with egg wash and into the oven and bake it for about 7-8 minutes and you're done. Sensation you get is umami flavor. You get the saltiness from the mushrooms, for the meat itself from my seasoning. The sourness will be from the red wine that I add into the mushroom pate. Bitterness will be a bit from the caramelization of the puff pastry. New Zealand lamb, it comes in a rack. We slice it up to 2 bones per piece. One portion is 4 bones. I marinate it with my special marinade for 24 hours. And then once that's done, water comes in, sear it on the charcoal grill to you get nice caramelization on both sides of the meat. Chuck it in the oven for about 6 minutes and you take it out and it's ready. Nicely done to medium. For the steaks, season with my seasoning on both sides. Put it on the charcoal grill on a high heat. Flip it every 2 minutes until you get to the required doneness. I've been doing this for quite a while now, so I can pretty much tell by sight. Whereas some people will have to tell by touch. So, I mean, different people have different methods. I've worked with this grill for almost a year now, so I know where's hot and where's not hot and, you know, the optimum place to cook a steak to the required doneness. I use a charcoal grill for a couple of reasons, but mainly because not a lot of places use charcoal. Charcoal imparts a certain flavor onto any meat that you, or anything that you cook over it. Although it's minute, but you still get that different flavor profile. Jimmy's Carbonara, I saute the onions and bacon first till they are caramelized and nicely brown. Throw in some white wine to deglaze, the milk, then the pasta goes in, and the egg yolk. Cook it up to a thick consistency, and you can serve it up. I see friends who are not well-to-do. They want to go out and have a good meal. They will always have to go to somewhere else where it's more affordable. It's not really atas food, I don't know, for lack of a better word. That's what I wanted to change the norm. Because good food doesn't need to be expensive. Even with good ingredients, fresh ingredients, cheap ingredients, you can produce amazing food, an amazing dish. If you compare our prices to anywhere else, to coffee shops, to hawker stores, to restaurants, anywhere. I dare to say we are one of the cheapest, if not the cheapest. Wanted to start this to prove to myself and to everyone else as well that you really don't need expensive items to produce good food.